Hi crafters, it's Hannah here from handcraftedcards.com. In today's video I'm going to be showing you how to make this envelope mini album. I'm going to be showing you how to bind your envelopes together, how to decorate it and how to wrap your chipboard pieces so you've got a nice cover as well. So let me just tie this back up. If this is the kind of video that you like, then please consider subscribing, because I do post new videos every week, three times a week even, and so there's always lots of tutorials for you. So let's get into the video. Okay, so the first thing that I'm going to show you how to do is wrap the cover of the envelope album. I've got a piece of chipboard that is, just grab my ruler, it's 6¾ inches by 4¾ inches, and you're going to need two of these. And then I've got some rich razzleberry cardstock. So for quickness, I'm just going to use my ATG gun, but you would really want to use double-sided tape. So you want to cover the entire piece of chipboard in tape. And you want to try and get as close to the edge as possible. But as I said, for quickness, I'm just going to use my big tape runner. Otherwise, you have to sit and watch me remove a million and one pieces of tape, but I would definitely use your double-sided as well. So I'm just covering the whole piece of chipboard with tape. I'm going to go the opposite. Obviously with double-sided tape you would just butt it up neatly, so you wouldn't have to go the opposite direction, but just for good measure I'm going to add some and a little bit of wet glue, just for a little bit of wiggle room. Not that we particularly need it, but there we go. So I'm going to bring in my rich razzleberry, and I'm going to go roughly about an inch from the edge, this corner here, and then top and bottom. So roughly about an inch in, and then just so it's even at the top and at the bottom. And stick that down. And give it a really good press. Glue on my fingers. And then from the other side, good idea as well to use your bone folder just to really smooth it down. And then just grab your trimmer and just trim down this edge here to an inch. So I'm just lining up the chipboard, oops, sorry you can't see, with the 1 inch mark there. Just roughly. And then you've got that. Now I am going to use double-sided tape for this part. So I'm going to line the entire perimeter of the cardstock with the double-sided tape. And this part you do want to take your time and get as close to that edge as possible without going over. So as best as you can, line it right up with that edge. I'm just going to keep going around. And then the left side. Oops. Then after you've done the outer edge, you're then going to do this edge by the chipboard and butt it up right to the chipboard and do that all the way around as well. So this is a very, very quick album to put together because there isn't really a binding on this one. You can, well, you'll see how quickly this one will be made. Okay. There we go. Okay. So just use your bone folder and burnish that tape down. Make sure it's really stuck well. That's another way to make sure that you get a nice neat finish on your album, is making sure all the edges are neatly stuck down by making sure your tape is stuck down in the first place. So we just want to miter the edges. I've made myself a little mitering tool, but you can buy them, which if I'm honest I would have done, but I couldn't find anywhere that would ship to England. So just so I can get an even amount when I miter the corner. So you just want just about an eighth of an inch left. And I don't know what else I could use to measure to make sure I've got it right. So I had a look on my favourite Pinterest and saw somebody had made these. So oops, there we go. So then you've got a nice even mitre all the way around. Okay, before you actually stick it, you want to train your cardstock. So fold it up and really give it a good press against that cardstock. So it makes it a little bit easier when you're wrapping it if you've already started to fold it. It can be a little bit tough to do this once you've taken the tape off the back. So if you start doing this first, it makes it a lot easier. So once we've done that all the way, then we'll take off the backing all the way around. And I add the tape before I miter the edges and not after, so that the tape is right up to the edge. So if you're to miter it first and then add the tape, it'd be quite awkward to try and get the tape right up to that angled edge. And you want your tape all the way up to the edges to make sure, like I said, it sticks down really well. So that's why I always apply the tape and then miter the corners. It might seem like you're wasting a bit of tape, but it's not that much tape and it makes it neater. So, and oh my gosh, it's really hot in this room all of a sudden. The sun is shining right in on me now and I'm not complaining at that at all, but I've got a big thick jumper on. Oh, that's better. Okay, so tape backing is removed. I'm going to do the sides, the shorter sides first. So again, just using my bone folder to press it to the side of that chipboard first, and then I actually pull it and wrap it around, so it's quite a tight wrap. So let me show you that again, and again using my bone folder to give it a really good stick. So I use my bone folder to crease it up to the side of the chipboard and then pull it as I'm bringing it down. So it's really nice and tightly wrapped, and that just gives the edge a neater finish. If it's not quite neat, you'll really see it. So before wrapping up the sides, you'll see that there's a little bit of overhang there on that corner. So what you want to do is just press that down and on the other corners as well. You might not see what I'm doing on camera, but when you're doing it at home, you'll see what I mean. So I've just folded that. There you go, you can just see where I've pressed that down, just in that corner, just that little bit, and it again makes your corner neater, so you haven't got so much bulk in the corner. So again, pull and wrap. Give it a really good press. And I'm always going over it and over it and over it more than once to make sure it's nice and neat. You can use two hands to pull it as well. It down onto your surface so those sides are nice and neat, and I always go over the edge just so it's nice and squared up. And there you go, that is how to wrap your chipboard for your cover. Now if you were doing a cover with a binding, it would be slightly different, but for this one you're just going to need two pieces like that, and that's going to make our cover. So we can move those to the side for just 1 second, and we will start on the pages. So literally what you need is a load of envelopes, and I've got 8 standard size envelopes from Stampin' Up, and you need to put them into pairs. Now how to how I'm going to show you how to do this next bit, it's not me that thought it up. It was, where's my other envelopes gone? 2, 4, 6. Oh no, that's right, yeah. another YouTuber that I watch, Marami, she is a mixed media art journalist, I think is the word, and she used this to make a art journal. But as I was watching it, I thought, oh, mini album, perfect. So, if you haven't heard of her, I'll leave links for her channel because she's awesome. So you're going to take your first 2 envelopes and open the first one. The second one, you're going to, let me just make sure I'm getting this right, flip it over. Hang on, I was thinking in my head. Yeah, okay. So the first one you've opened this way. The second one, you're going to flip it over and tuck it in. Like that. And then flap it over. So we'll do it for all of them, so don't worry if that didn't make sense. So your first one you open. Your second one, you're going to open it out, flip it over, and tuck it in, and then fold it back so you've got an opening there. And the next 2, exactly the same thing. Open your first one, open your second one, flip it over so they're one's facing up and one's facing down, tuck it in and fold it over. And then for your last one, exactly the same again. You're going to open the first one, the second one, open it up and flip it over, tuck it in, and then fold it. So then you'll end up with one envelope tucked into the first one, and that's where the opening of that top envelope is. So then we have 4 that look like this. So next you want to join those together. So you're going to take your first set of 2, your second set of 2, and exactly the same way, you're going to flip it over and tuck it in, and then open it up and then you've got the opening there again. Grab your second pair, flip it over and tuck it in, and then your last pair, flip it over and tuck it in. And this is the quickest way that I've seen to make, that made sense to me, to make an envelope mini album. So then there's a couple of different things you could do here. You could, if you wanted to, glue those flaps in, but I'm not going to bother because of how I'm going to decorate it afterwards. So as in where you shove those in, you could put some glue in there, but you don't have to. You can snip off an edge there if you want to make that a pocket, but again, I'm not going to bother with this one because I just want it just a plain, sort of plain album. And then the next bit you're going to do is basically to close this up, or to keep it all together, you're going to bring, sort of keep tapping it down to make sure it's straight, and then this flap is going to come round and form the spine. So I'm just lightly scoring it, and again making sure I keep tapping it to make sure it's level. And that score line is where the spine is going to be. So then you can just, it's a little bit difficult to show you, but I'm just reinforcing that score line. So it's basically the flap of the bat envelope coming all the way around to the front. So I'm just trying to make that crease nice and neat. Yeah, so then I'm going to put tape all along this part, and again I'm just going to use my ATG, and this as well doesn't have to be perfect because it will be covered. So but I do want to try and get as best as I can it all covered. And I'm just going to put a bit of wet glue here where the envelopes, excuse me, all join together along here, just so that they kind of stick a little bit together there. Not too much, just a little bit. And then making sure that they're level, and bring this back around. So it's flush. And that is basically the book. We're like nearly there already. So quick. Okay, so that is that's how you put all your pages together. So then when you open it up, you've got your pages. Now again, when it comes to decorating it, you can leave that open so you've got a pocket inside, but I want it all covered up. So let's get on to decorating. What we need basically is, we're going to ignore the front and ignore the back, but all the rest need to be decorated. So I've got the Blooms and Bliss designer series paper. If you haven't seen this stack, it's a really really pretty one. But what I like about it, that's one half of the pack are in these colour tones, which we're going to use. Then the other half is in these colour tones. So you can get two fairly different looking albums, or, well, more than two, out of one colour pack, which I thought was pretty cool. So, using the... there's some Rich Razzleberry, which is what we've used on the cover, Peekaboo Peach and Flirty... Not Peekaboo Peach. Sweet Sugar Plum and Flirty Flamingo. So I've got this... which one do I need? I've cut some already. I've got some, quite a few cut already. There. And I'm going to show you how I cut it. So I just so you can see how I'll get my words right one of these videos, honestly. I'm going to show you how I cut it so you can see how much you can get out of one sheet. Ugh. So I'm just deciding which one. I think I'll do another one of those. So these need to be 6¼ by 4¼. So I cut it down to 6¼ first. And I know you can't see the top of the board. I can't bring it too far down because it's off the desk, but I've just cut it down to 6¼. Then I'm going to cut that down to 4¼. And then another one, 4¼. And then you've got a bit left over there that you can use to decorate. So you've got two there. And the other half, I'm going to firstly cut that down to 6¼. So you've got a whole square there that you can use for decorating. And then cut this down to 6¼. So you've got three pieces out of one piece of 12x12. And if you was doing a card, or you can use this for more decorating in this album, but you've got some, you know, fairly big size pieces still left over. So that's how I cut my designer series paper down. Then before we attach the covers, I'm going to decorate the pages, or start to decorate the pages. So like I said, you're ignoring the front and then going to this one. So I'm just going to decide what order I want everything in. So let me just show you the three patterns. Remember, these are double-sided, so we will be flipping them over, but just so you can see. So those are the three, that side, and then those three are the other side. So I don't want two darker ones together, or two like those two together. So that's all really that I think about when I am deciding what to put where. This one I love, so that's definitely going to be on the first page. And then flip it over, and then that'll be my next one. And this is a tip that I learned from Kathy Orta King when you're decorating your pages, is to plan out where everything is going to be first before you stick it all down, and it honestly, it makes it go so much quicker. So where was I? So I've got that one, yeah, that one, then that one, so that one, that one. Then the next two, I'll go for this one. And then that one. And this one again. And that one. So I'm just pairing them up basically. That one and that one. Or that one. So yeah, before you actually stick anything down, decide where you want everything to go, or at least a bunch of pages. And it makes it, honestly, just doing that one tip of from her made it so much quicker. So you're not trying to work it all out as you go. Okay, so I think that is what I want. So the only thing that you have to make sure of is if you haven't stuck these flaps in when you come to decorate it, that you're not pulling it back out. So just be careful when you're opening your pages, because you could quite easily just pop it back out. But to stop that happening, now I'm going to make sure my double-sided tape goes over that edge. So that's the first two. I'm not going to make you sit and watch me do the whole lot, because that would be a bit boring, I think. And I'm going to use wet glue for this, just because that will make it just a bit stronger as well. So when the wet glue dries, it's quite strong. And I can make sure I get it in the right place. So here I'm just double checking that the envelope is in as far as it can be. And then when you stick this down, it's going to hold that flap into place here. So when that dries now, it's not going to move. So that is what I'm going to do for the rest of it, but I'll pause the video here and then finish that off and then come back. So after you have decorated all of the pages, this is what you will have, like that. And I used wet glue all the way through to make sure it sticks, and once the wet glue dries, it's quite firm, so the pages are quite strong. So just going through, making sure it's all stuck. Oh, and I missed two pages. How on earth have I managed that? Oh, that's hilarious. I can't believe I've done that. Okay, let me just cut some more paper and I can't believe I did that. Oh, what a muppet. Okay, so what were the measurements for those again? 4 1/4 by 6 1/4. Is that right? Let me just double check. yeah, 4 1/4 by 6 1/4. Oh dear. 4 1/4. Actually, what have I got? Yeah, I'll do that one actually. 4 1/4. 6 1/4 by 4 1/4. So, bear with just 1 second. There we go. So yeah, as I was saying, the pages will be quite strong for using the wet glue. Oops. And it dries quite quickly as well anyway, so. Okay. So double check if you're giving this to, as a gift to someone, that you have actually decorated all of the pages, because, you know, that'd be a bit weird if you gave it to someone and a couple of the pages were still black. But hey-ho, there we go. now all of the pages are decorated. I hope, I think. Let's just double check. Yep. Oh dear. So they're all done. And yeah, just double checking again. So the next thing to do is attach our covers. All we're going to do is stick one on the back. That's why we didn't bother decorate the front and the back. One is going to be stuck there and one is going to be stuck there. So it's a really, really simple way to add your covers. So what I'm going to do is get my ATG. And here's another one where you want to get right to the edges as best as possible. So take your time and add your new tape right to that edge, or as close as you can possibly get. And I am going to put some wet glue as well, just to be sure it's right up to those edges. Okay. So what you, when you stick it down, you don't have to worry too much about whether it's centered left or right, because you want it to go all the way down to this edge. You just have to be worried about top and bottom. So I found the best way to do it is to stand it up, and then you can just bring it up, and then you can check left and right. I don't know if you can see, you can check that it's level left and right, and then press it down. And then open up that back page. And give it a really good press down with your bone folder as well. And this is why you wanted to make sure that you get your glue right to the edge of the paper, so it's not lifting up. Okay, and then for the front one, you're just going to line it up with the back cover basically. So let's get some tape all over this. And some wet glue so I can get right up to those corners. Not so much for the inner bit, it's more the edges I'm worried about. Okay, then you just want to line up the back and the front covers. So I'm just going to pick them up like that and then just bring it together, and you can line it up left and right. Then open it up. Ok, go. That's the cover. Now you could, I've seen a few and they've wrapped the cover with paper, but it always tends, when I've tried it before, when you open it, the paper just gets creased, and I haven't found anything that I liked the look of, so I'm just going to leave mine. You could colour it, you could ink it up so it's not just plain white, but me personally, I don't mind it being plain. I may ink it later on, I'll see how I feel. So that is it with the cover, and it will lay down flat as well. You can just give it a good, I always go over all the pages a few times just to make sure it's all sitting nicely together and it looks neat and tidy. So decorating time. This is going to be a photo album, but let me just grab some of my pictures. Where are they? I'm still here, up there, some of them. Most of my pictures, I think, are in, let me just grabbed a random picture out of the pile, and that's what I found. Me, my niece and my mom. So most of my pictures are in this orientation, so I'm going to leave it. I'm going to decorate it so it's this way. Not that for the time being it's going to matter, because I'm not going to put any words on the front just yet. But if that's what you're going to use yours for, then just think about which way your pictures are before you start decorating it. So I'm just going to add some cardstock. This is the Sweet Sugar Plum cardstock, and I've just got two pieces that are 6 1/4 by 4 1/4, and as always all of the measurement will be in the description bar below, and then over on my blog I'll have all the close-up pictures so you can see completely how I decorate it. So at the minute it doesn't matter, actually. I think that's my favourite one, so that's going to be my front. Not that it matters yet. So firstly I'm just going to put some cardstock on the front and the back and just centre this front and back. And you know when we was cutting the designer series paper for the pages and you had these squares left, I'm going to use those to decorate the front. So these actually are they just under 6, they're both 6 3/4 by 6 3/4. What I'd ideally want it to be would be at 6 instead, 5 3/4 even, but it's not, so no worries. So one, you're going to leave the 6, oh my word, let's just start that whole sentence again. These are both 5 3/4 by 5 3/4, and you're going to leave one side at the 5 3/4 and then cut it down and the other side to 4 inches. So then you have that. Oops, sorry. My goodness. So you've got that. Before I stick that down, I am going to, just deciding, yeah. I want a ribbon closure. So I'm just going to take some of the Sweet Sugar Plum. Oh no, it's finished. That's not going to be enough. Ooh, is it just? Ay, ay, ay. That is just barely going to be enough, isn't it? And it's going to have to be because I've got no more. But it's got this weirdness on it. Oh man. What else could I use? I wanted to use this colour. Oh, there we go. We've got that weirdness off. Let's see. As long as it's enough to tie a little bow. A really, really little bow. Let me see. Oh. That's tiny. No, that's just too small. Okay, so. Well, what I could do, because I've got a random short piece, is piece it together. So if I still wrap it round, but this one, take it to about halfway at the back. So I've got a nice long bit there. And then that one, yes, that's what we'll do. Okay, so stick this down. I'm going to use my tape. I'm standing up now because I want this to be as close to the middle as possible and even top and bottom. So I'm going to take the tape off. This is the, which is the longer one. Is that the right one? No, I want this one first. Okay, so I'm just checking. Yeah, okay. So I'm just going to stick that onto the tape. Make sure it's well stuck in the tape. Flip it over. And then add another strip. It's a good job I'm doing an order tonight. So I can order me some more of that. Where's my poke tool gone? Oh dear, I'm losing everything today. I'm actually going to make sure it meets about halfway through. Just to be on the safe side. And join it up. Why I've just got a random little piece there, I don't know, but it worked. So then, and it's totally out of focus. How long has that been out of focus? Oh, I hope that hasn't been out of focus for a really long time because I haven't looked up for a while. I'm just not having a day of it today, am I? Oh, okay, so that's the ribbon attached. If that was out of focus, sorry. But I've just attached my ribbon and then the designer series paper is going to sit on the top of that. So, just making sure I've got the join is at the back. So I'll do that first. And just using the wet glue, it'll hold that ribbon in place as well, because it'll seep through the ribbon a little bit. front piece. So that's lovely. I have a think there. Where do I want my flowers to be? That way. So that is pretty much it, I think. You could obviously put a title on here, because I'm not sure which exact pictures are going to go in here yet. I'm not going to do a title just yet. I don't know whether I will add that later when I've decided what pictures exactly is going to go in here. And this will be our closure. Just tie a bow. Got a nice good size bow there now. And that is it. So I hope you like this album and give it a try. It's a really, really quick and easy way to make a quick album. So it just opens up there, and then you've got your pages, and this is just the right size for photos. Let me grab that one again. So you can see it's just the right size for a photograph. So you could have some journaling up the top and your photo at the bottom, or just completely photos, which I think is what I'm going to do. So I've got a load of photos printed off. If you want to get your photos printed for free, I use an app called, let me see if I can find it. I'll show you the app that I use. It's completely free. Free Prints it's called. And this is what it will look like. And it is literally, it's free. All you pay is your post and packaging. So, and that's only a couple of pound, I think. So that's what I use to print all my pictures. And I think I can give you a code to get a discount. So if I can, I'll and you get 47 free prints a month. And you know, I've never used that many, even when I've printed loads and loads off. So it's really good. I think I can give you a code so you can get a discount if it's the first time you use it. So have a look in the description, and if there is one, I'll add it there. So that is my mini album today. I hope that you give it a try. If you do, let me know, and let me know what you think of it. And also thank you to Marimi for the tutorial on how to bind the pages. Again, I'll leave a link to her video that I watched and that inspired me to make this album. So thank you so much for watching. I hope that you liked this video, and then it wasn't out of focus for too long. Sorry. And I hope to see you again. As I said, I post every week, every Monday, Wednesday and Saturday. There are new free tutorials, completely free tutorials. And also over on my Facebook page, there are tutorials there as well. So thank you very much for watching. Thank you to everybody for liking, commenting and subscribing. And I'll see you in the next video. Bye.